A very good morning to all. All of you, welcome back to our social class. And I hope all of you done your homework, isn't it? Okay, good. So in the last class, we have discussed about the different means of communication. Okay, the different means of communication. And we talked about postal system, telephone, mass media, and computer. Okay. So in our textbook, there is a little more details about all these means of communication. So let's read. Okay. So all of you take your textbook. Page number 196. Okay. So the first one is postal system. Today, letters can be sent all over the country at a nominal cost. It is important to address them correctly, adding the PIN code. PIN is the short form for postal index number. In our country, it has 6 digits. Parcels too can be sent by post. If a letter has to reach the intended recipient very quickly, the sender can use the speed post facility. People also make use of the many courier services that deliver letters and packages as soon as possible. Okay, so children, now look at the picture. Letters are sent through inland letters, envelopes and postcards. Okay, now look at the textbook. No more. India was the first country in the world to send mail by plane when 6,500 letters and postcards were flown by plane from Allahabad to Nainital on 18th February 1911. Okay. India was the first country in the world to send mail by plane when 6,500 letters and postcards were flown by plane from Allahabad to Nainital on 18th February 1911. Okay. The next one is telephone and fax. Telephone and fax. The fastest method of voice communication is the telephone. There are telephone exchanges throughout the country that connect calls in seconds. Fax machines are connected to telephone lines. Printed matters can be sent through fax machines. A fax machine takes a picture of a printed page and sends it to another fax machine anywhere in the world by means of electric signals. In addition to regular telephones, which are used at homes and offices, there are cellular or mobile phones. These can be carried around in pockets and purses so that people can make or receive calls wherever they are. It is possible to send instant text messages, photos, or videos through these mobiles from one phone to another. The next one is mass media. Ready? Okay. Communicating with a large number of people at the same time is possible through the radio, television, and newspaper. Communicating with a large number of people at the same time is possible through the radio, television and newspaper. These means of communication are called mass media because they reach a large number of people, the masses. Television is both educational and entertaining. Unlike the radio, the television or TV enables us not only to hear what is happening around the world, but also to see it. Satellites are used for long distance communication, making it possible for us to view an event live the very moment it is taking place. Thus, we can enjoy a football or cricket match being played in any part of the world from the comfort of our homes. Okay. Newspapers and magazines are available in various languages. These carry news reports as well as interesting articles. Okay. So children, the next is cryptic. All of you ready with your pencil? So write with me. Okay. The first one is, mass media comprises what? Mass media comprises radio, television and newspaper. Okay. So write it on your book. Mass media comprises radio, television and newspaper. Okay. The next one is, dash are used for long distance communication. Okay, dash are used for long distance communication. What are used for long distance communication? Yes, satellites. Okay, satellites are used for long distance communication. Write it on your book. Okay, children. So once again, take page number 196. Okay, look at the bottom of the page. You can see the what is postal index number, courier and telephone exchange. Okay, so let's read. Postal index number, a group of numbers at the end of an address to help the postman locate the exact area where a person lives. Next one is courier. Someone who delivers documents and parcels. Okay. Next, telephone exchange. Place from where all the telephones of an area are controlled. Okay. So children, now let us see a small animation video. Okay.
Modern means of communication. Sachin and Meena have reached Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Sachin calls his father to inform him that they have reached their destination. Modern means of communication has brought the world closer. Earlier, it would take days, months, or maybe years to send a message to people staying far away. In fact, communication of early humans was in the form of actions or carvings on caves or trees in the pictorial form. As communication developed, people started using different types of languages to communicate. The invention of paper and press brought a drastic change in written communication. Initially, letter, telegram, speed post, etc. were the only means of communication. Later, the most remarkable invention of Alexander Graham Bell, that is, the telephone, started being used. Telephone, pager, mobile phones, etc. are considered as instant means of communication. The fax machine helps to send facsimile of documents and pictures instantly. Computer with internet and email facilities comprise more advanced means of communication. There are two types of communication, personal communication and mass communication. Letter, telephone, mobile phones, etc. are means of personal communication, while press, television, radio, etc. are means of mass communication. These help to spread news and information on a large scale. Also, the impact of such communication is immediate. Newspaper is one such commonly used means of mass communication. Hundreds of newspapers are printed in a variety of languages. These cover information about sports, politics, recruitment, property, etc. Mass communication helps to spread education and make people aware about the happenings in the world. It is also a means of entertainment. The artificial satellite made by humans helped to gather information by orbiting the Earth. This information, in turn, helps to forecast weather conditions. The weather report on radio and television makes people alert, and hence, timely precautions can be taken.
So children, today's class ends here, and your homework for today is you have to collect the pictures of any postcards, telephone or mobile phone or fax and mass media. Okay, any of mass media, and stick it on your notebook and send me on WhatsApp. Okay children, so let's meet in the next class. All of you, thank you.